Hi, it's Ms. Parrott, and this video is about how to convert grams to moles and moles to grams in chemistry. This is a combination of multiple skills we've been developing over this series of this course. Links to the videos on how to do these two things are in the description below. So we're going to be using our basic unit conversion process of multiplying fractions with calculating molar mass, because we're going to be developing our own conversion factors to do converting grams to moles. If we're going from grams to moles, we're going to put molar mass in the denominator of the converting factor, or the converting fraction. And if we're going from moles to grams, we're going to put molar mass in the numerator. Again, all this is so that our units can cancel. Let's go through a step-by-step list and do a couple of examples. First, you're going to take what you know from the question and put it over 1 to make it a fraction. Then you're going to use the periodic table to calculate the molar mass of your substance. Then you're going to set up your second fraction so that the units cancel. So if you have moles in the numerator of the first one, the first fraction, you want moles in the denominator of the second fraction and grams on top. Then you want to multiply across the numerators, multiply across the denominators, then solve by putting in your calculator numerator divided by denominator and rounding according to your teacher's instructions. If you're in high school, you're probably going to be rounding to significant digits. If you're in middle school, you might be rounding to like tenths place, hundredths place, thousandths. Just be sure that your answer has the correct units. Let's do some practice. First, we'll start out with moles to grams. This question asks, how many grams are in 4.5 moles of sodium fluoride? I've taken 4.5 moles, M-O-L is how you abbreviate that in here, of NaF. So this is a new addition to how we write units. You actually have to write the element or compound next to the unit. So 4.5 moles of sodium fluoride over 1. And then when we set up our second fraction, again, we have to find the molar mass. And when we take the molar mass of sodium and add it to the molar mass of fluorine, we get 41.99. Whoops. 41.99 grams of sodium fluoride in 1 mole of sodium fluoride. We set it up this way so that moles of sodium fluoride cancel out. All right, so we're going to cancel our units, multiply across. 4.5 times 41.99 grams is going to give us 188.955 grams of sodium fluoride over 1, right? 1 times 1 is 1. And then you'll round according to your teacher's instructions. So in my case, we're going to be rounding to the hundredths place. So if that's the case, then I'll have 188.96, because this 5 and above, we're going to round up. Okay, so 188.96 grams of sodium fluoride. That's the full answer. All right, next, let's turn grams to moles. Similar process, not exactly the same. How many moles are there in 98.3 grams of aluminum hydroxide? So take what we know and put it over 1. 98.3 grams of ALOH3. Yes, you have to write ALOH3 every time. Over 1. Then calculate the molar mass of aluminum hydroxide. We'll take 1 aluminum plus the molar mass of 3 oxygens and 3 hydrogens and add it all together. And that's going to give us 78.01 grams per mole. But I need
I've got grams on the top here, so I need to have grams on the bottom here. 78.01 grams of ALOH3 per mole in 1 mole of ALOH3.
Now these will cancel. So you see how when we're going this way, we're gonna put our molar mass in the denominator.
We multiply across, or we cancel our units. Cancel, cancel. 98.3 times 1 moles. So we're going to have 98.3 moles of ALOH3 over 1 times 78.01. 78.01.
In our calculator, we're going to put 98.3 divided by 78.01, and when we do that, we're going to get 1.2601.
So let's round to the hundredths place again, which would be 1.26, and our units, moles of ALOH3. And that's our final answer.